this show. Today we're going to work on this guy, and that guy, maybe, I don't know. Today we'll see how it goes. Got some pretty good music here tonight. So here we are. It's Saturday, or it's whatever day you're watching this, obviously. Sienna, though. We'll probably put the yellow okra and the burnt umber back, but we're going to really work with some oranges. It's going to be a wacky painting, that's all. Brian's here, what's up? Otaku, your friendly otaku. How nice to see you, bud. Happy weekend to you all. I hope you all having a fun time doing what you want with your family and friends. That is a shocking color I'm using right now. I say let's go for it, yo. like orange sherbet. It's a happy color. Fluid. That's what we're looking for here, some fluidity. Sample, yes, I am doing okay. Thank you for asking. Just, you know, having a day. Got to work a little late today, you know. So, settling in. But yeah, man, I'm having a great day for the most part. And you, sir? Hope you are doing well, and thank you for the likes, guys. I appreciate it, Otaku. I'm sure, Brian, you've done your job. That's wonderful. Thank you. Pull a little bit this way. Glad to hear you're doing great, Brian. Wonderful. I don't think Otaku's here, but if you are here, Otaku, I hope you're doing well as well. This color for the top one. might have to use it. It's a little pumpkin-y. I like it. Got that white in there. Makes it look like orange sherbet. Let's see what we can do here. Amazing the way the colors work so differently together. That is when they're against black or blue or browns. Should be an African band here tonight playing music, so I should be pretty good on the copyright claims unless they do something that's pretty big. Thank you. The color's not really bouncing, but it's probably good for a backdrop. So I'm gonna keep going, just to add to the peach that's in there, I guess. It's a different shade of it, that's for sure. Looking for the blackness in the paintings. I'm just covering that up with some orange at the moment. Cholo Andrew, what is happening, dude? Thank you very much, bud. These are the three I'm kind of working on together, I guess. I have another one sitting on the floor over there. It's big. That one's kind of a solo project when I'm tired of all these three. This one I'm working on has been my third attempt at it. So we'll see how it goes. Bringing some color back. How are you doing on this fine weekend evening? Feel free to say hi to people here and go visit their channels. Do what you do if you want to see some new content. I do this every night in addition to the gaming. So, you can find me here, bud. Monday night we should be doing a promotion evening. So, that'll be fun. Everyone will get a chance to have their channel up, put a video up, whatever they want to put a video up of. The latest thing on their channel or what have you. And we can all meet each other and say, hey. Just relaxing this weekend. Tomorrow is your graduation. Well, dang, sir, congratulations on that. I think I remember you talking about that before. Again, congratulations, man. So it's kind of infringing upon weekend stuff. That's cool, man. Whatever you do in life after this is, shooting towards some sort of goal of yours. Goals change. I've had a few. Sure, man, relax, get ready. You don't have any speeches or anything to give tomorrow, do you? I mean, it'd be cool, but, it scares me right off the bat. Like, what? Certificate, right? It's good. white clouds for a minute. Let's focus on that for a second, shall we? Probably sitting there wondering, why is he ruining that painting? You'd be right to question.
So I'm just pushing the limits of what's acceptable, you know, in paintings.
And what's acceptable to me, I mean, this is nice, and this is a great way to get... This is insane, so I'm going to really work my way out of insanity. I did that once before with this painting, and it seemed to work out pretty good. I did a lot of prints, and people like this one. So when it comes to insane, that's pretty about as insane as it gets, and I'm hopefully going to pull that off here again. But as you can tell, that's a lot of getting through. So that's what we're doing right now, is just getting through. Trying to see if it works. If not, dude, I'll paint over it again and start over. I am not a proud man. Thanks everyone for stopping in. Appreciate it. Keep reminding people here on Facebook that if you're on Facebook, come on over to YouTube or Twitch, and you can typey. Or if you're just watching it on your smart tube at home, you can get on your phone, also watch it on your phone and type in on your phone. If that might be easier, it's like sending a text message. Eh? Possibilities, eh? Good start. And I want to transition in these paintings from somewhat of a real painting that you're traditionally used to looking at into an evolution of something that you start to realize it's nothing like you've ever seen. That's where I'm trying to get with these darn things. We'll see if I achieve it. Everything is red from top left to the bottom right, unless you're from an Asian country where they read differently. They view their art differently as well. So, but generally people view it from this way to this way. So I always try to keep something realistic in the left corners. It seems that's, that might be where it's moving towards. I don't know. This doesn't seem real at all, but you know who we are. Mistakes on the painting, and that's generally my rule, is just to cover up mistakes and then just see how it goes from there. And boy, are there a lot of funky times on this painting right now. But we'll get somewhere. We'll get to a wind.
Excuse me, sir.
Hey.
Sorry to bother you.
It's all
are
good.
Are you the proprietor of those paintings outside?
One of them's mine, and this is what I do now.
Oh, yeah.
And
they're very, very talented, very, very eclectic. Are you the blue one, or you're the blue one? Okay.
Yeah.
Who owns the wood one with the lady?
Michael Pasquet, that's this gentleman right here.
Yeah.
He did a year at the Guggenheim in New York.
Yeah, I know, and I can totally see it.
Yeah,
legit.
Yeah.
So what is he asking for that piece, do you know?
$8,000
for a piece? And you're doing a lot of this glass art?
What I've done over the years is collected glass. I had a store downtown, there's my shameless promo right there on the wall from the New York Times. I basically had a store downtown that was just promoting a lot of the local activity in glass.
Okay.
Maybe here.
Yeah.
Yeah. We treated it as a TV show back in the day, so right now they're out back smoking.
So we had a guy in the office being a producer, essentially.
Gotcha.
So they'd be back there blowing glass on the TV show. And this is about 11 different artists in glass here that I've collected over the years. And yeah, my paintings, huh?
They're awesome.
Yeah. That's one of the latest.
What I like about it, though, is this, the lining.
Yeah, man, that's what I'm doing. I'm trying to create something that's different. And then what I'm doing here is I'm balancing them all. So there's an extreme version. I'm kind of doing that again with this. Then more mellow, where you kind of just, well, this is more mellow. And then almost non-existent of lines until you get up close. And you start to see that it's all line work. And then over there, there's the canyon one is amazing, I think.
Yeah.
Just in depth and the amount of lines that are there.
Yeah.
I do this all live on YouTube.
So I moved to Tucson about 4 years ago, man, from downtown Phoenix. Before that, we're from Portland. But, man, like, I knew a lot of graffiti artists, man. This one guy I knew, his name was J.D. Snyder. Really good graffiti artist, man. But what he would do is, it wasn't the lines, but he knew how to draw the lines to keep the color within the lines.
Oh, man, yeah. They're good at what they do, man.
Oh, yeah.
They're good at what they do. Me, I take my color theory, my knowledge of color, and I just work with it. It's just tons of lines. Tons of lines. This is my most mellow version of my line work. I think it's, I call it my kitchen cactus.
Actually, I'd say that's him, and that's him.
Thanks, dude. I mean, check this out.
What are you asking?
That's a print. That's already sold. I'll sell you a print, $50.
$50 for a print like that?
Yeah.
Is there any way to digitize to make like a printed T-shirt
As a matter of fact, that one is on Redbubble and Fine Art America. You could have a shower curtain in that, or a T-shirt, a pillow cover of that one.
Really?
Yeah. Not everyone is on that kind of thing. I've only done that to some of them.
No offense. If you have that, and that on pillows. Yeah.
I didn't bring my
drink. On a long pillow.
I have a cup where I put that one inside the Starbucks cup. You know, it's a 2-ply cup, and I just put that print in there. People love it. People at Starbucks love it. So what I'm doing is trying to just do different things. Yeah.
What are you doing for the summer? Just chilling.
I'm here painting every day. This is what I do. I have a YouTube show. We're live right now. Jason, pleasure to meet you.
Hey, John.
Hi, John. Pleasure. I'm asking two. Yeah. Here's the deal. The first 10 paintings I made started in Christmas, basically, where I was starting to finish paintings. I finished 10 paintings, gave away 3 to family members, sold 7. Sold my Bob Ross one recently. And then I think I have another one that's in print that is not here.
This is just in print?
Yeah. So you said that's what I'm doing, and so I've been very lucky to show up here and create a style, if I want to call it that, because I don't think I've ever seen this happening. And I've heard that again and again. So I'm trying to fine-tune a style. I'm trying to do it live in front of the whole internet, the whole world. Here, that's what they see.
Oh, wow.
That's live right now. And basically, we sit here and we rap, and I sit here and talk to people about my paintings, about their paintings. Soon we're going to paint together as a group. Like, the internet's cracking. it's a crazy place.
I swear to God, I love your style, man.
So thank you very much. Like, there's another one, and another one. These are weird. Extreme. I also like that cactus one there. And then this one.
For video games. Not my video game room, bro.
This one. So I play video games. That's my YouTube channel. It is a video game channel and that I paint on. So what I'm trying to do is experience both worlds and share both worlds with people who are into video games, maybe. This is a latest one that is...
That's like Fire and Ice.
Baddie. Okay, so this is the Tool song right in 2 to me. This is my experience with that song, right in 2 by Tool. Angels on the Sideline, Thank God, like what the hell did you give these
guys? The coldness, why did you give that shit to them?
Look at what they're doing with it. So this is how I'm trying to bring this out, but I don't know, I've never done human form other than Bob Ross. I've only stuck with landscapes. I don't know what an angel really looks like. I don't think it's human. I don't think it's, it's just this energy power.
God-fearing, awe-inspiring, usually in a form of fire.
Yeah, we recreate something that is something we recognize. So I'm really trying to find that within this line work. This is driving me crazy right now.
You know what?
But it's a lot of
fun. I would try to color within the lines. Let's, I would say throw pocket colors.
Yeah, okay. That's interesting.
Oranges and some reds.
Yeah, that's awesome.
Fire and fury.
Yeah, yeah,
and
I get it.
Because if you're, you know, because I mean, the song is basically you abandoned us, basically.
Yeah,
it's, like,
it's,
you're going
it's
for
heavy,
that.
Dude. It's heavy. So in 1997, this was what I was doing. That's the only thing I've ever done. It's called A Storm in Heaven. It's the only campus work I've ever done.
Yeah, what do you want for that?
I'll make prints of it. I'm not selling the original ever of this yet.
Really?
It's one of those things, yeah. It's just 1997. I've never really.
I know, man. What if it was in a home that you knew for a fact was guaranteed to never leave that home?
That'd be dope.
And be passed through families.
I mean, that'd be cool. But look at it. It's not one of the up to this caliber of paintings.
Yeah. But if you were to print it.
Yeah. Then it's just like I can, you know.
So how much would you want to print that?
The prints, they're probably $1. Same as these. Like, they're $90 for the bigger prints. Because they cost me.
Dude, we're gonna come back. We're gonna talk.
You're awesome,
bro.
Hey, I'm here every day. Thanks, guys.
Yeah.
Thanks for coming.
It's great to meet you.
Pleasure to meet you as well. Hi, ladies.
Hi, how are you?
Doing well.
How are
you? Awesome. As you can see, my paintings. As you can see, I'm live here on the internet and the TV here. So I try to, you know, share this experience of being an artist with some people on the internet.
That's very cool.
The glass in here is all locally made. Almost every one of them is one of a kind. Made a very interesting collection over the years, you know?
I bet. Very fun. I love that one.
Well, this one?
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm really trying to figure it out. Thank you. Maybe, I mean, it's... These are difficult, because I don't know.
I like them.
Oh, it looks like I got blue on it. Now I gotta fix it. Sweet. But yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
It's a style, you know? Something I'm working on.
Yeah, it's very cool.
Thank you.
Thanks so much.
Have fun tonight.
Thank you. Should I shut this?
You can leave it open.
Yeah.
My poor ears. It's gonna be a lot of that tonight, folks. On the game, hello. Love you too, man. Thank you. Thanks, dude. I appreciate the watch time. I need the watch time. That's awesome. Ribs is in the house. What's up, Ribs? Chaos. He dropped in for a second, I'm sure. Nice to see you guys here. Welcome. Hope you're enjoying your weekend. Watching the game. Heard that. Crack open her beer. Chill with some potato chips. Choking on a mint. But I'm fine. We're around a bunch of people who know CPR, so it's all good. Or choking. Whatever. Finish that little candy mint. Dangerous, man. Made me cry. Nothing makes me cry, man.
Wow.
some Muzak. Are you ready for the Muzak? Like this painting. It's interesting how they start and where they get to. These crazy paintings. Cover up these little blue dots that I've been flicking paint everywhere. You've got to be careful, people. These people have so much fun, huh? Great. Oh, here's a copyright claim. With it. I'm still just going to look at it. I'm going to have it here. It's just inspiration to a path. I don't know what it is yet. The painting itself is allowing a lot of freedom. You see, most. Well, there is a guided path, okay? There's the goal. There's a goal at the end, man. Ding, ding, ding. Right? So it's obvious that that's a thing. But it's unobstructed by a bunch of physical things, except for the path. The path is elaborate. So we'll see what this painting has to offer this little brain up here. Until then, we'll keep looking at it and thinking about it, wondering why. It's like this whole show, I guess, is this moment, not the final moment, yeah? I mean, I'm gonna run through paintings over the years. I've run through 10 since December. It's all on YouTube, you know, and I'll just keep running through them because it's really not about the paintings. Hopefully I sell them. I mean, that guy, I would like that guy. Do you notice I was bold enough to say I wanted 2 for it. So, that was the first time I ever asked for that much money with a straight face for a canvas.
then on one of these nights, I got to make them wait 24 hours before they, I got to make them come back tomorrow. So that, because I smell the alcohol on the guy's breath. And when you're that interested and you're that focused, it's not, you know, healthy. Coming from the guy who gets way too interested and way too focused. I may know a little bit about that. Ask anyone or look at any of my past endeavors and you will find excellence. Just messing around, man. It's the weekend. We got some African music to listen to. It's gonna be nice. We'll be like on the Serengeti. A responsible seller? Hey, bro, yeah. I'm the one who has to be here. If I was like in a gypsy cart, you know, traveling from little shanty to shanty, maybe then, you know, I might sell a little snake oil here and there. I'm not saying. Maybe I wouldn't. I don't know. I wouldn't. I don't have a cart. And there's rarely a shanty. But it sure was easier back then to do such a thing. I feel that, you know, being grounded, having the responsibility of this real estate. Basically, they know where I am. Possibly one of the worst capitalists I've ever met. So, I got that going for me. I try to capitalize, but then I realize it happens all the time. I leave this one up too, because it shows people on the internet and out in public here that this may be sort of the end game for something as crazy as this. So it helps with that too. Just the social aspect.
What? Oh, I gotta bring your eyes in here. Bango. Bango.
Welcome to my store.
Need this and that. You can actually have that painted on pillows.
Yeah, you can do that on pillows, shower curtains. I've been really thinking about that one on a shower curtain. I don't know, there's a room in my house. It's funny to see my family on a shower curtain.
He said he would print this one.
Star in Heaven, yeah, that's going to be happening soon.
He's got another one in back. I still say orange, crimsons, reds.
All right, that's a ballsy move, but I'm going to work on the thought process behind it. I like it.
Good, how are you?
Very well.
Wait, did you do these paintings?
Yeah, that's something I kind of gave up on. This one I am in the middle of.
So this one has some squiggly lines in the landscape.
Yeah.
Not in the sky. And that's the opposite.
Well, that has both.
Yeah, that is.
Yeah, so what I was doing, this is like a very early painting, this one behind. Uh-huh. And so I was kind of just figuring out what his style was, and I'm still trying to figure it out, but
Yeah,
thank you.
Scribbles, abstract.
That's one of the last of my original 10 paintings that, so I've sold 7.
Cool.
Gave away 2, and you're looking at the last of the first 10.
And how much you sell these for?
That one, took some hours. So what if I take an offer, I take a really good offer?
Yeah, no, what's your asking price?
$500.
Very good.
Whereas this one is a way longer evolution of said squiggly lines.
Yeah.
To where it started off where I could move into some landscapes.
Yeah.
This is like a good psilocybin kind of afternoon.
Uh-huh.
And then I worked into like mellowing that out a little bit the best I could. Kind of transitioning, you know?
Yeah.
And then really kind of just figuring out the distance with what I was working with.
Yeah.
And then I tried to do that. That was fun. This is one of my latest and greatest. I love it.
Yeah, that's a nice one. That's quite a saguaro there.
It's quite a saguaro.
Did you see one that looks like that?
Oh yeah, I mean, I've hiked in these mountains since 92. Every angle, every trail.
Yeah.
Bushwhacked off of trails.
You moved it to Tucson in 92?
92.
So did I.
Yeah, right on.
Where did you move from?
Cali.
Where?
Emmett.
Emmett, that's
near Palm Springs.
Oh, it's near Palm Springs.
East of Dar. Yeah. And then this is what I call my kitchen cactus. I feel that this is just nice. You know, it's not all of this. It's more still all line work here, but it's something where I've toned it down.
Yeah. Now, I used the term, what term do you use to describe this?
I don't know yet.
Okay.
You have an idea?
I use squiggly lines.
Hey, I know that. I've heard it twice.
I'm sure you've heard that before.
If you twice today, yeah, but maybe.
Other people have said that or not?
Sure. Yeah, they have squiggly lines.
That's the best term I can come up with immediately. I like it very much. It's
thanks.
A very cool style.
It seems to gravitate towards emotion over time. I seem to find qualities while doing line work where I'm like, oh my goodness, and then I can accentuate that. Whether it's a wind or a breeze, whether it's a stillness in the air, even I feel that's here. This I feel is on the east side of Mount Emmett, looking towards the mine out there, where you just have this huge valley and the mine would be out there. Essentially the process, like I'm working on this one, it's an early process. Sooner or later it'll be as cluttered as probably all of this.
So you use a very fine brush like that for these lines?
Everything.
That's a long
Yeah, well I lost my brush the other day. The shorter one that I was very happy with, But this was my first one, and I just jumped back to it. I don't mind.
Okay.
I work with closer things. As you can see, I'm not working on a lot of distance right now because I don't have the fineness that I really want.
Yeah.
And even with this little brush, it's not as fine as I need.
So the finest one is what size?
The lucky part for me is about a half the distance up.
Yes.
And it's about, I'd say a third less bristle maybe.
Right.
It's not as fat.
Is it like a 10-0 or what?
Yeah, probably something like that. Uh-huh. Like a 1, I think, you may know more than me.
I'm
not paying attention.
That's the finest I can find.
Yeah, there you go. I was thinking of taking a razor and just cutting out all the brushes I could. Every bristle, just bring a thing and then just have one. Go to town. Let's get one hair and start working. Slow this process down a little bit.
Yeah.
So here's the thing. I'm live on the internet every night. I have a YouTube channel.
Oh.
That's essentially what they see.
Oh.
So it's kind of fun. It's inspirational, I think. But I also have a video game. What I do is I play video games on YouTube. Yes. I'm doing so. Look, I just got a new subscriber. So I've realized that video games just go so far. You know, it's just a gaming channel and live painting show.
Cool, man.
And every day I just upload two videos. One's a gaming video, one's a painting live video.
Do you do any of the glass work?
No, my work is not up to this caliber by any means.
Okay.
I made a pipe. It's still in existence today.
Very cool. I like this
mandala. Yeah, the mandalas are what I used to do. I used to do nothing but mandalas.
Is this that guy who paints on TV with his
name? Ross?
Ross. Yeah.
That's him, buddy. I sold that painting last week.
Cool, man.
No, I guess it was 2 weeks ago. But thanks, man. I mean, this is a labor of love. You know, I paint houses in the day to afford this.
Yeah.
And I'm trying to make things happen. This is Michael Pasquet. He did a year at the Guggenheim in New York, by the way. Commissioned artist there. The big one outside is his, as well as, if you can tell, he is a classical artist, yeah? Something very legitimate about his works. So he loved my store downtown, right? I used to do live glass blowing in the front. We had a stage.
You did glass blowing?
No, this is what we did. This is what was my store. So I just had the setup.
Somebody else doing it?
I just had the setup. Yeah. So we had a lot of people. I rented a place upstairs and put 5 benches up so that we could have a whole bunch of people come down. I'm just trying to support that local activity because I own a smoke shop. My shameless promotion is right here. New York Times.
Lost my paradigm. Cool, man. New York Times, they were about this shop right here?
Yep, but it was downtown.
Oh, downtown.
It was before I moved over here.
So how's business since you moved here?
It's not anywhere near the same, but what I do is different. I just kind of just changed up my attitude. I went for the starving artist, and I thought, well, I'm no longer going to have a retail store downtown anywhere USA, which tended to pay the bills, you know, give a paycheck. So now I paint houses. I'm sponsored by my family, you know, and so they really are seeing something here over the past 2 years, and so hopefully I'll keep this going until YouTube starts giving me some money. Twitch, Facebook, whoever. I'm thinking of I'm working on how to get sponsorship from painting, like paint companies, brush companies. I'm just trying to work my way into a system.
So these are all acrylics?
Yeah. Yeah, and I'm allergic to the paint.
Wow.
Yeah, so do you hear this? There's a fan blowing in here.
Yeah.
It's two centrifugal clutch fans that are sucking. If you put your hand here, you could actually feel the air just going that way. So it never has to affect me. All the heavy paint air just goes down.
Good.
So if you need one of these too, I can build you one in your house.
box.
That could be one thing I do. Help save your life. Alex Gray is one of my favorite painters. My tribute to Alex Gray. That only took about a year to figure out and work on. It's not done, of course.
I know Alex.
Yeah, okay, cool.
I used to live in Boston when he was there.
Nice.
And then he went to New York.
I bought them paintings.
Whew. Yeah, I know.
I mean, come on. That's enough to make me do this. That's all I'm saying. That's all. Because it's absolutely nothing that becomes something over this period of time. Thank you very much. Yeah. Me too. I think it needs a frame. I feel that it's missing. Like, I didn't like this painting until I framed it. Once I framed it, I was like, oh, I get why people like it. I didn't see it. Even this one, I kind of enjoy it, but now that I've seen that one framed, once I framed this one too with the same kind of frame, like this.
That blue one does not need a frame.
No.
Going to the edge, pulling the edges. But see, the kind of frame that I like is the floating frame.
Yeah, okay,
there's a
sure.
Gap.
Yeah, totally.
And that way, you're not covering up the front composition.
That's awesome. These are awesome.
Yeah. Because these,
Well, these are the smaller.
They go right to the edge.
So these are the cheaper canvas. They accept these kind of frames very well. Uh-huh. Whereas I get what you're saying, when you're working with a professional thickness of a canvas, you're definitely going to want a quarter inch maybe sometimes, an eighth at least.
Yeah.
But I get it. I like this one too.
Yeah.
It's very just Art Deco. To me, it's like this. It's everywhere. it's against the rule of art. You know, there's no focus on that painting. It's just everywhere. I like it. It's like a bathroom painting to me. You know, something hang over your toilet. I like it. It just reminds me of the idea of a cactus.
Yeah.
And it's cactus in Hawaii, so or Mexico. You know, okay. It's definitely like a seascape behind it.
It reminds me a little bit of this artist who shows in New York. I think his last name is Ross, but I forget his first name.
Okay.
But just a little bit.
Well, cool, man. If you know people, you want to share my work out into the world, you let them know I'm here. How's that sound? I'm not proud.
Okay.
You're like, dude, I know this artist in Tucson. He's doing some wacky stuff. Maybe in a few years he'll be doing some potential.
Yeah. Are those your drawings?
No, those are a local guy. My store downtown was 2,500 square feet, 2,200 square feet. So I had like an art gallery in there as well, hence Michael Pasquet. But we used to do art shows. That's Fish Karma. Do you remember a band in town called Fish Karma?
Pretty good name, but
yeah.
I've never heard them.
Oh, it's like a 90s, 80s, 90s punk.
Okay.
Jello Biafra kind of push. Towards punk, but real desert because the guy's local. Anyway, his art name is also Fish Karma, and those are two Fish Karma things.
Oh,
I was so happy to have him in the studio. I was like, I have your albums from a long time ago. Like, I do. I have tapes of Fish Karma. It's ridiculous.
That's a trip.
Yeah.
You've got a lot of neat things, like your little jewelry.
Yeah, this is Mary Beth Caputo. She did all the jewelry here that's, that has to do with Nick Crowley.
These are great colors.
Yeah.
You've got a lot of neat stuff here.
Over the years, I made quite a collection. As you can tell, it's even the New York Times said it was a glass pie in paradise.
How long have you been in this?
Two years in May. So it's now been 2 years.
Well, I'm glad I got to see it.
Yeah, bro. Before what? I moved to New York and got famous. Is that what you're saying? I'm just kidding.
I don't know where you're
going. I don't know either, man.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stay here. I love this desert. I moved here in '92. It's beautiful.
Cool, man. Well, thank you.
Thank you very much. Enjoy the show tonight. Have fun.
Okay. Thanks. Have a good evening.
Thanks for letting me spend your ear. I'm not getting any painting done tonight, folks. You guys want to hear this or what? Should I just turn this off or what? Hi, Arthur Moorhead. How you doing, bud? Sucks when I just start to paint and then I got a bunch of people coming in. That's okay though. A lot of original pieces of art that are locally made.
Okay.
And then what I do here is this. I do paintings.
That's what
I do them live on the internet. I have a lot of fun with it. Little YouTube channel.
Cool. Also, you do it on YouTube?
Yeah.
All right.
So Space Galleria is my YouTube channel.
What is it called again?
Space Galleria.
Oh, okay. It's the like the sign out there.
Yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Gotcha. I saw that out there.
Yep.
That's pretty cool.
Thanks, man. Yeah, man, I sold that. These are all prints, which I can get to you. 90 on the those, 40 on the squares.
Right.
60 on that. Sold that. I've been having a banner year here, man.
That's good.
It's been nuts.
Good.
I've been having so much fun.
All right. It's probably a good location right here.
I mean, it's all right, yeah, for sure. I mean, luckily I can do something like this. All locally made, by the way. As you can see on this TV above you, well, that thing's zoomed in to all heck right now, but I had a producer in the back office, and we did this as a live show on the internet back in the day. So it was the front of my store. Yeah, so you could see frog beer blowing glass. It's a lot of fun. And now I do painting live on the internet. Gotcha. Three right here,
yes.
And this big guy right back here.
So you spend most of your day here and then at night people come?
No,
maybe not.
I'm only here at 5 to 9.
5 to 9?
Yeah. Paint houses in the day to afford this, what I can.
Wow.
Otherwise, I'm just trying to do this. I've sold paintings since January. I've been very lucky. And people actually like my art, they accept it, they want to put it in their house. I'm like, okay, sweet. It's a beautiful thing.
It is.
It's changed my life forever.
I used to have a smoke.
You love and love what you do.
Yeah, struggling through it all. I used to have a store downtown, which is all these little trinket stuff that you're going through and you see. But yeah, it was literally a smoke shop here in town. Space smoke shop.
Is this ceramic or steel?
Ceramic.
Oh no.
Photos. Yeah, they're prints of my work because people wanted them. So I sell prints. A pretty neat way to keep the art alive, too. And right now, see, you're live on the internet. So here, I'll bounce into the camera view. Boop. There you go. That's what they see everywhere all over the planet right now.
Who? Anybody who's
too busy. Several planet. All seven of them. I think there's seven people hanging out right now. I have a small channel. Someday it'll be thousands of people.
Someday?
I've seen people play a video game with 30,000 people watching them.
Yeah, man. Minecraft. Had to start somewhere.
It's a whole
Minecraft. Multi-billion-dollar industry.
Everyone. Yeah, it's been fun. You're gonna have fun tonight with the show. You're gonna eat.
Yeah, you dance.
Nice.
It's been a long
night.
Day already. Well, we came to the wedding.
Okay.
Tonight? Well, there was a wedding during the day. A lot of these people here are just.
Oh, I did not know that. What a nice place to get married.
Thank you.
Change it just in case someone was there typing in, look at that. Hello, lady. That's hilarious, dude. He's with potential client. Well, you guys are great for showing up. None of them are potential clients, and all of them are, but they're not here to buy art. They'll buy art 3 months from now after they've thought about it and if it's a really good decision. And I've sold seven paintings, so seven people have decided to make that decision. Cheering section, dude. You guys are awesome. So you don't mind just listening to this crap? Thanks, Beyond. Appreciate it. It is a passion, man. It's a non-monetarily gifted passion. Yeah, I sell art, but how much it costs to live. If I was to try to sell that much art, I'd better raise my prices. Which I'd love to do by next year. I'd love to be able to sell, say, 12 paintings in a year, all at once at one of these crazy art fests. Hey, how you doing, man?
Good, how are you?
Very well.
In the car?
Yeah.
Are these your paintings over here?
What's happening? How you doing?
Good.
Good.
Whose paintings are those?
Long time no see. Mine?
Yours. Okay.
Where? Where?
Right over here next door.
Mine's the blue one. And then there's Michael Pasquet. I used to have it in my store downtown.
Are you Bernie?
Sorry?
Are you Bernie?
No, that's Robert Bernie. That's another guy.
Okay.
Yeah. He's in Colorado. I have full access to him, and I try to sell his work for him.
Okay, that's what I need to know.
Nice to see you.
What's happening? It's
been a minute.
It has been.
Welcome to my new store.
Let me ask you the one with the purple cactus.
Yeah. Still doing in Tucson?
Oh, I love it, man.
There you go. That's the answer I love to hear.
Well, I've been here 10 years, you know. I have no business here. Like, I don't do any of these things. A genius, I did some stuff for OG last out of Las Vegas. I just did a bunch of stuff for Mustafa, what's his name, Rob? The guy with the mustache. I can't remember. I do so many.
Well, good.
Yeah, we're doing it here like 10, 15 jobs a week. That's a lot.
Awesome. Glad to hear everything's working out for you, Dale.
I like Tucson a lot because we don't have any clients here, but we work from here, you know, so yeah. We don't have the stress in Dallas or something. And I love the weather here, too.
Yeah, the weather's
the
beautiful.
Amazon is horrible, cool. Well, I'm glad you're chilling out.
Yep, 2 years now, just painting. Glass museum and painting.
Downtown, she had this nightmare.
It's just big.
I don't like dealing with all those people.
And then you got the downtown, yeah, it's downtown USA.
Yeah.
Anywhere. Sucks. It's
like
full of struggle.
Yeah.
You know? And
well,
if you want
it. I got my feet on the ground over here,
yeah?
Which I didn't have my feet on the ground when I moved over here because I didn't know what the hell I was doing, but. After I got my feet on the ground, we've been in that those warehouses. We just opened another warehouse for our screen printing.
Nice.
But for our glass customers. So if we do glass for them or straws, then we do we can do their t-shirts. But anyway, so yeah, so we're expanding, but we're nowhere near anybody. We're just so quiet. Just lock ourselves in there.
Sounds like a dream.
It is. We were working last night at 4 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, I'm coming out with an article for Arizona Bilingual Magazine.
All right.
And it'll be an article. That's a beautiful painting right there.
Thank you very much. Something I'm working on.
It'll be an article in Spanish, English, and Portuguese. So,
to the bone.
To the bone. Was it Paulo Portuguese?
Yeah. Oh, hell no. Hell no.
I do.
To the vein, to the bone. That's it.
To the vein, to the bone, yeah.
That's it.
He'll follow Portuguese.
There you go. Yeah, I can pick it up. I can see that they're speaking Portuguese. That's a tough call in itself. Because
yeah.
You want to tend, you want to lean towards Spanish, and then you're like, wait.
Yeah. No. My wife doesn't speak
English. Joie, la, la, la. So once you start seeing that, I'm like, oh, Portuguese, gotcha. Because I deal with the internet. I'm live. I do this on YouTube.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, she doesn't speak, she doesn't like to speak English. She can, but she don't like to.
Well, it's not as pretty, eh?
It's hard for her. It's hard for her. She's not a... Okay, well, listen, Shannon.
All right, Dale.
Good. All right, I'll see you later.
Definitely. Take it easy.
Nice store.
Thanks.
It seems safe. I went in some other store. It seems safe over here. I went in a store over there on Geek Glass or something. Oh, man, they must have had $100,000, $200,000 worth of merchandise in there. All these artists, you know, everywhere.
Yeah.
I mean, they had some shit in there, like Sagan.
It's not your fault. Don't worry.
They had Mothership and all kinds of stuff.
Yeah, crazy shit.
Yeah, and I was like, man, somebody could just come in there on them and have a good end of it.
Well, you know,
it's dangerous. But
I'm fine, it's simple enough then. It's all good, don't worry. Mary Beth Caputo did the earrings, by the way.
I'm sorry?
Mary Beth Caputo is a local artist. Yeah, everything in here is local. So I kind of just made a point of that.
Well, be good, Shane. I'll see you later.
All right, cheers. And I sit here and I do the paintings.
Very cool.
Thank you.
Open.
Well, welcome to my humble little star.
Over the years, just collected a lot of pipes. They're locally made, one-of-a-kind pieces of art. Some of them are $1,400. These are like $1,111. I didn't make up the price. It's just the artists I've collected, okay?
Oh, gotcha.
So it's kind of like a high-end art deal with the glass. But then what I do here is I'm live on the YouTube and I do a painting show every night.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Yep. And I'm live right now. I'm just here. Yeah, this is basically what they see when you tune in. Yeah, and I talk to them, we hang out, listen to music. And it's fun.
Wow.
It's a fun time. And I get to see my paintings come to life over time.
And what is your medium?
Acrylic.
Acrylic.
Yeah, and I'm so excited. I just found my brush again.
Yeah, I know. When you have that favorite one.
Yeah, well, this one's a small one, and I needed a small one to deal with a lot of the back,
all
the stuff in the back. Yeah, I can do this stuff with the bigger one, but like this is what I call the bigger one.
Oh yeah.
And that's
oh,
small.
Yeah.
What's
oh,
your
yeah.
site here called?
Space Galleria. Let me show you the YouTube channel. And now here's the thing with it. It is a gaming channel, and what I've done over the years is inspired, hopefully, the youth to, look, I'm a gamer, I get it, gaming's not going anywhere, but look at what we also can do. The people who made the games were incredible artists. I mean, the games we play are just unbelievable in the art that is involved. So I'm hopefully going to tie that together. And you know, when entertainment changes and there's no more Fox cable TV, and it's just the internet, I will hopefully have a show there already in play. Yeah, and right now I'm looking at the, 750 subscribers. So I'm about a year old.
Oh, I was going to say, how long have you been at?
Yeah, about a year, which is pretty rapid, I think. And yeah, very new, and I just enjoy it. I get to sit and I get to obviously play some video games and do a lot of painting. So it's fun.
Interesting.
Yeah, thanks.
We were just sitting here listening to music. We thought we'd better come.
Quite
look.
A spot, right? Yeah. Monterey Court.
Is it always this busy?
No.
Or is it just the wedding? That wedding?
No, actually, this band brings a huge crowd. The wedding obviously put a big thing on it. But Tuesday through Sunday, there's people here and there's a live band here.
Wow.
So you can always.
Wow.
Yeah, so you can bring guests that come into town, visiting, whatever. This is a great place because there's dinner. There's a bar, it kind of helps, you know, everybody's doing their thing. There's music, there's everything.
There's art.
Yeah, there's art.
Food, drink, what else do you want?
What does that say? I love what?
Jamaica, J-A. That's a Jamaican flag. So these hats are Grassroots Hats. It's a San Diego company where you can make your own hat for $500. Basically, they give you, this is a local glass blower. And he gets to design his own hat. And then, so they made him like 25 or whatever. And they take half the proceeds and they donate it to whatever cause you want. So it's actually a very cool company that you get hats out of it. So this is a local glass blower. This is a DJ, another DJ. This is actually Cypress Hills, one of the rappers on this. I got his hat. So, you know, just, anyone can have a hat. You can have a hat.
Think about that a while.
There you go. You can do your own design.
For your hubby. Right.
So yeah, the glass is very unique. It's like this, for instance, this is one of my favorites. It's a Margaret Sinzer collaboration. She's from Australia and she's kind of like a squared up lady. Let's just say she's pretty square. She doesn't work on pieces. Which is what I call a piece. But these guys at Zombie Hands are super charming fellows. They obviously talked her into a nice collaboration.
You had one of those in your house.
It's a one of a kind. That's the only one. That's why that's on the screen.
So you can get that.
This is made of extinct glass. It is, right? It catches your eye.
Yeah.
Because it's made with old television tubes.
Oh my god.
Cathode ray tubing, so it's extinct glass, literally. So it shimmers differently than all the other glass on the planet. It's full of leads and metals and poisons that we can never even conceive of. So for $1,400 you can have that and not use it. I wouldn't recommend using that one.
For health, anyway.
You would have to talk to me.
But see, I just find interesting collections, you know, like this was painted on with glass, not burnt, in that pattern. Unbelievable. It's $1,000 mug. And, you know, to somebody who respects the artist and knows what they do, that's really well.
So did you grow up here?
No, Southern California. I moved here in 92, though.
You've been here a while.
Yeah. I like Tucson a lot. I love it here, obviously. I even moved to Seattle in 2000 to 2004.
Okay. Well, I can understand that. That's where I'm from.
Oh, yeah?
I miss it in the summer.
Yeah.
Did you miss it once in a while?
No, I was long wearing it all the time. I was cold. I'm just a cold human. I'm skinny.
Yeah.
I need this sun. This moment where you can go outside here and it touches your bones, you will never get that up there. The sun is not that strong. Alice, I missed that so much. I had to get this just off. Yeah.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, thank you very much. And if you know people, just share what I'm doing. Like, look, the New York Times even came and just said, hey, yeah, that's my shameless promotion right there. That's from my downtown star. So, literally, if you, you know, I think I'm doing something positive. No, that was just before. That was when I thought I had money. And then we realized, oh, it's just all going away.
So Sunday and Monday are your Target weekend.
Kind of, but I'm going to be here tomorrow. I'm here usually on Sundays, and I say I'm not, but that relieves me of that, in case I have to go see people. Then there's that. Thanks, ladies. All right, this is the Not Painting Painting Show. Welcome to the Not Painting Painting Show, where I sit and I say the same things over and over to people. I say, this is a painting, and this is local glass. And this, and this. Ah! We got the African music playing. Painting Painting Show, starring Shane. See, in this painting show, you gotta watch between the paint. Just gotta watch between the paint.
We suggest you do the same. Get some drinks, but have a couple of drinks. Have some of this food here. I recommend several things. I like the mushroom burger, and the chicken pot pie is so good, and the macaroni and cheese is to die for.
It's like a whole bunch of old deadheads here.
You got a great work.
I got guys here tonight with giant rooster hats. I'm not joking. And if he comes in the store, I'm going to ask him to come over here and get on camera for y'all. Because he's got a giant rooster hat. And I think that should be shown.
Thank you.
It's gonna be that easy. Tons of lines. Thank you very much.
Nice.
Yeah, that was a mess last week.
It was like a monsoonal experience.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
And I really don't know what... Okay, so this is bugging me because obviously it's a landscape painting.
Yes.
And not a landscape setup. Usually landscape paintings would
right
be
up,
landscaped.
Right up. Yes.
So I'm having issues with this whole thing, but I'm liking it all the same. Because I feel that, like, I'm sitting here staring at it, and I haven't really touched it in a few days, but I'm trying to work into, I thought something was going to go here.
Yeah.
But I don't think nothing goes there. It's hard. It's hard to, like, let go of it,
mm-hmm.
or maybe see it.
I really love the OPTOs.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Especially the one in the background.
Yeah, me too. I mean, I have fun with these stormy...
I love the stormy ones.
Yeah, I have fun with them. That one is like the moment lightning strikes, and it kind of shines off over everything.
What do you usually sell something like this for?
Okay, so I'm asking $2,000 for that.
Wow.
I know, but here's why.
Yeah.
I have to hold on to these papers.
Yes.
For I'm putting this one, and then I finish this one and that black one. Are all gonna go like a two-buck with me.
Nice.
I need that.
Yeah, absolutely.
So here's what's happening.
Yeah.
I offered the one on the top left over there, I was like, I'd love $1,600 for it. And then he was like, I'll tell you what, I'll give you $1,000. And I was like, okay.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Because I'm no dumb.
Yeah.
And what I do here is I make people wait. I'm like, just wait, come back, I'm here every night. But nevertheless, I couldn't turn away that. And so that's where I'm at as an artist. Let's say I offer a price, yes, and then let's say you come back and you really want it, and you're like, I'll give you this, and I'll be like, all right, probably. But what I really like to do is get these two bar at the right time.
Yeah. What's your name?
Shane.
Barrel.
All right, Barrel.
Do it.
Yeah, thank you. I'm working on it.
All right.
It's a process
it's nice
every day.
It's nice to stop by and see.
Yeah, thank you.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. I'm honest. I want to get these paintings to a place where a bunch of New Yorkers come out with a bunch of their money and they're like, we're going to go buy Southwest art in the Southwest. We're going to buy art in not Sedona. Like, we have this thing called Tubac here. And it's kind of like Sedona's art community, except I think it's even more prestigious. I think Sedona has the crystal therapy, you know, kind of shit. And then they have the art too, because the artists follow the crystal therapy. What's up? How you doing tonight?
Good, how are you?
I'm well, thank you.
Are you grooving?
I am so grooving. I had an M&M on my forehead right now.
You do?
I did. I ate it.
Some people were really admiring that wonderful painting.
The guy with the rooster hat?
Yeah.
Are they high? Yeah.
I don't know.
He's wearing a rooster hat. I wanted to get him in here to get him on the internet. I was like, get your rooster hat in here, bro.
Do you?
I can go. No. Don't you ask him. It's got to be me now.
Okay.
I like your African belt.
Is your shoe? It's your really big shoe.
It is my really big shoe. Thank you. It's my really big shoe. Welcome to my shoes. I say that all the time on that I am being that character. My really big shoe. Thank you for filming my really big shoe. Tonight we're going to have them. On my really big shoe, we're going to have a really big painting of some blue.
That's good.
Thank you. What was his name?
Ed Sullivan.
Ed Sullivan.
Yeah.
Yes, we're going to have a really big shoe tonight. It's going to be great.
You did the sky, and then you took that.
Don't yell at me.
Oh, what?
Huh?
Then you took that.
I'm live on the internet right now, lady.
You took that.
How you doing?
Color and put it in there. Starting to freak me out, and then I went, okay, that's good.
This is the third time I painted this tragedy. I think I'm gonna throw this painting away in the long run.
No, it's working.
Maybe.
It's starting to work.
It's starting to work.
It's
okay.
Happening.
Because that's what happens here. Is that this one used to be as tragic as this one. But now it's this, and people like this one.
Yeah.
So, it's transitional. It'll happen. Rooster hat. His girlfriend's barefoot.
I know, that's dangerous.
It's not only dangerous, it's just, she's in the restaurant. I don't give a shit that she's outside. You don't hang out in a restaurant barefoot.
Well,
it's a deep subject.
I would. I used to be paid to do it. But
well, that's these hippies that own the joint. They don't mind.
But that dance floor is not good for bare feet.
Oh, no, dude.
It's, they need to read the book. But I'm not going to tell them. In fact, she owes me money for that.
Put a dance floor in?
What?
Be all like break dancing? So what?
Got nuts and chocolate today. I'm not hungry.
Nuts and chocolate.
Nuts and chocolate. I'm not hungry.
Today's program sponsored by Planners, nuts and chocolate.
Because I have.
It's not really sponsored by Planners. Don't eat that. It's terrible. That's what happens when Planners don't give me money. I tell people their product's terrible.
That's
is that
what
wrong?
Happens when
am I going to get sued?
Hungry.
Yeah, I have to eat, and nuts and chocolate help me.
I find that nuts are very good.
Calm down, lady. You got it. Are you,
am I?
Obsessive?
Kinda.
A little bit? She just organized a bunch of glass.
Pendants.
And then she made the thing. She messed with my obsessiveness. If you like, you can have it that way, or you can have it that way.
But
this way seems a little weird.
This is better.
All right, I'm going to go with it. I'm going to let you do you.
Room right here.
To put, like, drinks down.
Yes.
I don't want people putting drinks down here. What the fuck? What do you think this is? Do you know how much glass is beneath you, that drink right now? If they were to spill a rum and coke into that glass.
This is water.
I know it's water. That's why you're cool. You're cool.
You know what I like about this band?
What?
They take a lot of drinks.
Oh yeah, they smoke in that
so
reefer?
So I can come in and just...
Do they like smoke that reefer? The King's Blend?
So they can socialize.
The African
herb?
Did
you put more white on this?
Hell no, I have not touched it. It's sacrilege to touch a painting after you've signed it.
Oh, quit it.
Quit it indeed. I'm not gonna just keep painting a painting after I said it's done. I could fix a painting after it's done, but I can't add to it. What, dude? Do you want to see yourself on camera?
No.
You totally do. You don't have to go away.
No,
you
won't.
Look at the distance. Here. I'm off camera. Look at me. I'm not even on camera.
I used to get videos done, and I couldn't look at them for 2 weeks. Look. This is fantastic.
Well, that's your fingers.
This is wonderful.
That's your fingers. You're going to have to go further. I think she's having fun with it.
No,
folks.
This painting is lovely.
Well, thank you. I'm glad you.
I really like it.
Thank you.
Yes, I do. So have you sold anything this week?
This week, no. I
you
just sold my Bob Ross. I mean, what is this?
You know what you can.
Where am I? New York.
You could frame these and you could put them like, dum, 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 like 1, 2, 3 when you cut.
like that one, and then they, well, see, what I'm doing is just trying to fit paintings in here.
Yeah.
And soon, every day, I keep, you know, I can move them around, fit them in.
Okay.
Honest, I don't. How's it going tonight?
Oh, good. How are you doing?
Very well, thank you.
Are you the artist here?
I am an artist.
I love the district.
Thank you so much.
It's a combination. It's a Van Gogh
district. In a way. I've never seen a Van Gogh painting in person, so I wouldn't know really how they're constructed.
I went to the first impressionist show out of Russia with my boyfriend in college.
Same painting.
Same length.
Same painting.
Yeah.
You're funny. Yeah. Fun stuff. Thank you.
No, don't
say that. I made the mistake of saying that to a pretty girl the other day. I was like, come back.
And she came back.
No. I mean, she's... It's a girl I'm here to worship. I'm just like, oh. I've always been kind of... You take a guess.
Okay, it's either the blonde, sparkle, I call her sparkles.
You would.
I think, is it a blonde?
She sparkles.
Tiny blonde.
Yeah, tiny she is.
Yeah.
Seems like a glorious, wonderful thing.
Yeah. I thought, yeah.
There is no other.
You don't like the dark haired one?
Nope.
Yep, she's pretty cute.
Yep.
You know what?
But yesterday she comes in, she was like, I like this one. I was like, oh, cool. And then she just ran. I was like, come back.
You know, they have to do that.
I know. So I know. She liked it.
My allergies are acting up.
I will lock you out. I will rummage through your purse, lady. Just kidding. I'm not going to rummage through her purse. I just like to give her shit. A nice lady. I think I'm gonna have to stop this stream, folks. There is nothing here that I'm doing that is entertaining.